The story of the Grandview 2021 boys soccer team is one to never forget. It is a tale of tribulation, perseverance, and triumph, securing this first state championship in boys soccer in the 23-year history of Grandview Athletics. It all started back in the young months of August. Off to a rocky start, Grandview started their season with a road trip of Fort Collins, Hinckley, and Mountain Vista. They fell to 1-2 out the gate, and things weren't looking all that promising for the season. Then, the three-game win streak against Gateway, Ralston Valley, and Rocky Mountain brought them back up to two games above 500, going into the home game versus number 8 Valor Christian. They unfortunately let in a pair of goals to the Eagles and failed to score any themselves. After their tough loss to Valor Christian, the team was looking forward to bouncing back against 2-2 Highlands Ranch at home. The game did not start out as well as the team expected, with allowing a goal, then another, and then one more. Sitting at halftime down 3-0, things didn't look too great.
When we were down 3-0 at halftime to Highlands Ranch High School, and they were not a good team, and we came into that game thinking that we were going to obliterate them, and we found ourselves down 3-0 at half, and we like that was really the low point of the season. And so we really had to look inside, and we really had to like just gut it out. And Coach Wood basically sat all of us down, and instead of yelling at us, he was like, I want you each to look around to each other around the room, and he was like, I want you guys each to say that I believe. And then we all said, I believe. And then after that moment, really, we really believed in what Coach Wood was saying, and we really just believed in ourselves.
Out of the halftime break, Grandview had fire in their eyes. They stormed back with senior defenseman Ben Beckman scoring on a penalty. Then, after some time, an encore with 2 minutes left to go. Although the comeback valiant, the time was not plentiful, and near misses came back to haunt them as they came up short 3-2 and dropped to 4-4. The next game was against undefeated and sixth in the state rival Cherokee Trail.
Another big moment was the CT game, and so CT has been trash-talking us since the beginning of the season, and they're our rivals just down the road.
Cherokee Trail's a rival that it's one of the teams you really want to beat.
The surprise hero of the game for Grandview was sophomore defender Ryan Williams.
And Cherokee Trail at that time was undefeated, and it was kind of a game that we wanted to make sure we won. So we spent a lot of time kind of preparing for them, trying to get the right players out there, and then just kind of learned what some players could do that I hadn't seen already during the preseason. I think Ryan Williams was one of the big ones. At the beginning of the year, I just kind of played him sparingly just to give him some time and to kind of see what he could do. And at times his touch wasn't quite there, and he was kind of felt like he was out of control. And then when we made that switch at Highlands Ranch, he went and played a lot. He played a lot against Cherokee Trail, actually saved two balls off of the goal line that would have gone in for goals. It obviously would have changed that game, and I never took him off the field after that.
The Wolves came out of that game a different team than the one that came in.
I think that Cherokee Trail game, getting that early goal and then coming back right after scoring and getting the goal right after they scored was kind of a huge turning point for us in the season.
Beckman.
Goal!
What a shot!
30-yard line.
What a shot from Ben Beckman.
Ben Beckman finds the tiebreaker.
After we beat an 8-0 team, being 4-4, you realize you can kind of beat anybody if you play like that. So I guess it kind of inspired some of the boys, and we took that into the rest of the league, and that started the run.
We knew how big of a moment it was for all of us to come out and to play our best against CT, because it was not only the beginning of conference play, but CT was just, talking a lot of trash earlier in the year. And so we just really wanted to shut them up and put them in their place. And so after we got that win, momentum just started coming, and then it was wraps from there.
Grandview then played the number one team in the 4A classification in the state, the Mullen Mustangs, who sat at 8-0. Sophomore goalkeeper Nikhil Patel turned the corner on the season during the game.
I'd have to say during the Mullen game, it was right after we beat CT. We were like doing amazing, and there was one save I remember where I just had a crazy reaction and just dove and tipped the ball to the crossbar, and that save helped us like win that game. And then from there on, we just won every game and dominated all the teams we played.
Fresh off spoiling two perfect seasons on two consecutive Tuesdays, in came Cherry Creek. Grandview kept it rolling with a 2-0 win, and they were not looking back, with routes of Eagle Crest and Smoky Hill to follow. Grandview was in position to win the Centennial League title. The only things that stood in their way was an easy game versus 7-7 Overland and a trip to play the number one team in the state. Arapahoe came into the battle 12-0-1 and 4-0-1 in the league compared to Grandview's 5-0-0 record entering the game within the conference. This meant that if Grandview was able to get the win or tie against Arapahoe, they would just have to beat Overland to secure the Centennial League championship. Despite the valiant attempts of both teams, Nikhil Patel and Arapahoe's goalkeeper Alex Bissett were not letting anything up. Going into OT, both teams were tied at 0-0. After that, the same sat, and eventually after one more OT, Grandview secured the tie 0-0 on the stout defense of the Wolves and four saves from Nikhil Patel.
If they can't score, they can't win.
Yeah.
Grandview was just an Overland win away from the 2021 Centennial League Boys Soccer Championship, and to secure Grandview's third Centennial League title in 5 years, cementing a dynasty era for the boys soccer program. Grandview did win that game versus Overland, and with it, the Centennial League title. Despite this, Grandview did not get ranked. They actually remained unranked in the top 10 Chassa polls the entirety of the season and went into the playoffs as the number 11 seed. The Wolves stared down a tough schedule of opponents in their quadrant of the bracket, with number 3 of Fort Collins and number 14 Mountain Vista both being losses that they took during the regular season. Grandview would start out their playoff journey with number 22 Regis Jesuit coming to Legacy Stadium. The game remained silent for 69 minutes until Grandview broke the tie with a Blake Harwell goal on a cross by Ben Beckman. Things were looking pretty good for the Wolves before Nikhil Patel had to leave the game due to cramping after making an acrobatic save. The backup came in, but after a stoppage, Patel returned. The equalizer came from Regis with just 7 minutes later and forced the game to go to overtime.
So, once I came back in after I had a calf cramp, and it was pretty bad. And I went out, and they had one shot on goal, and our backup did a good job to save it. And then I went back in, and they scored, and our morale just dropped tremendously.
In OT, momentum was low for the Wolves, and things were looking rather bleak. Patel kept Regis at bay and buying time for a walk-off winner. Courtney Hall got the ball and used his body to stop the defender's clearance attempt, sending it to Luke Williams with a man to cross.
Luke puts a ball in. Everybody in the field figured he's going to cross the ball. He just blasted in the goal. And so I think that at that moment, I was like, I think this team can go all the way.
Two right now. Courtney Hall, he gives it up. Luke Williams. Luke Williams is going to send it in. That's it! Luke Williams with the goal! Wow, that was almost all Courtney Hall. He got that stop, kicked it around the defender, and Luke Williams was able to put it over the keeper to give Grandview the 2-1 lead. That is the game. Grandview moves on.
The overtime goal against Regis was probably the one that I was like, wow, we're able to come back from, having Nikhil having to go out of the game because he was having cramps, and a couple other guys hurt, and trying to shift people around and everybody moving around, and the boys didn't panic.
The goal was the walk-off that Grandview craved and kept the season alive. Next up was a match with the third undefeated team of the season, 6 seed, 15-0, Silver Creek. But the outlook was a lot different this time.
Well, we just came off of a crucial 2-1 win in overtime against Regis, so we were like, okay, we beat Regis. Regis was a good team. They were a lot better than we thought, and so we got past them, and we were like, okay. Silver Creek was coming into the game 15-0, I'm pretty sure, and so they were undefeated. They've only been scored on a couple times, and we knew that we had to come in and we had to play one of our best games, even though nobody's ever really heard of Silver Creek, and so we knew the conditions were going to be bad up there. It was going to be slippery and cold, and so we were like, if it's bad for us, it's bad for them as well. So we just got to go through and push through and fight and work our butts off. And then The bus ride up there was just a lot of, it was crazy because it was like a lot of waiting. And then as soon as we got on the field, we were ready. We were determined.
Now on to the quarterfinals due to a rapidly collapsing bracket headed by a 14-seed Mountain Vista win over number 3 Fort Collins allowed Grandview to host the quarterfinal game on their home field. They easily disposed of the Invaders and moved on to play number 7 Legacy with a packed crowd at DU. This is the height of their defensive play, piecing together a gorgeous game that led to a victory and a ticket to the state championship in heroic fashion with a goal with just 1 minute left to go in the game. This was the fourth time that Grandview had gone to the boys soccer state championship with trips in 2004, 2007, 2018, and now 2021. All the past three trips, Grandview came up short. Coach Wood had coached in the latter two trips and felt something different about this game versus number 17 Fossil Ridge.
I mean, I felt really confident. I felt like watching Fossil Ridge on film, and I'd watched them several times. Creek had played them twice. I felt like we matched up against them really, really well. I didn't feel like there was any one player from them that could really take over a game and was going to be a problem for us defensively. Obviously, their big thing was, I mean, they hang around in games, then get into overtime, and all of a sudden they just magically win games, which has been, it was fun watching them, because every game they come out and win that. But I felt like it was a team we could match up really well with, and we could actually get out and control the game. And as I've gone back and rewatched the game, I was pretty amazed at how well we did control the game for most parts of the game.
The atmosphere was big, and fans came out of the woodwork in mass, making the hour-long drive up to Switchback Stadium to support their Wolves.
It's amazing how much better you play when you're playing in front of a big crowd, and you know the crowd is cheering for you, and just the excitement of, you know, the fans and the parents. The parents, I mean, they've made part of the turnaround. Because I think after the Highlands Ranch were 4-4, they're just kind of going, oh man, I don't know how this is gonna turn around. And all of a sudden we turned it around, and they got more and louder and more excited and more supportive. And more students came out, and you heard students talking about it in the hallways. They talked about it in my classes. They talked to the players. The players would come out excited about, hey, you know, we were talking about soccer in class today, and people were stopping me in the hallway and saying good luck. I mean, it was huge. And that following made a huge difference.
The mounting pressure of the game and the big stage led to different effects on some of the players.
Well, so it was my first chance to actually play for a state title. But last year I was in the semifinal, and it wasn't nearly as big as the state championship. It was pretty special. And the people I was talking to, they told me, you're not going to be in this position. You don't know if you're ever going to be here again. So give it all you got, and you might as well.
And we fought our butts off the entire playoffs, and we made it there, and we were like, all right, this is it. It's time, because some of the seniors and juniors that were on the team last year, we made it to the Final Four, and we lost to Creek, and we were like, we don't want to go through that whole experience again. And so after we beat Legacy in the Final Four, and we had the momentum going, and we basically just went and we played super hard and we played super well because we wanted to get the first one ever for Grandview and imprint our names in the history of the school.
The Wolves started out strong, striking first blood in the 21st minute and again in the 36th minute with goals by Charlie Lucero and Luke Williams. Entering halftime, the Wolves led 2-0. Morale high and momentum higher. The half started out relatively slow, but in the 71st minute, Fossil Ridge made it a close game, scoring their first goal of the game on a chip over goalkeeper Nikhil Patel. Tentatively, Grandview prepared for the possibility of a Fossil Ridge equalizer. Short-lived were their worries, though, as Dylan Thompson put the game away with a goal in quick response. The 73rd minute marked the start of a party that was unique in Grandview history, and with that, Grandview secured the state title.
It was, you know, I've coached for a long time, and I've dreamed about it for a long time, and I've always thought if I ever got lucky enough to coach a team and win a state title, what would I do when that game ended? And I kind of always envisioned myself just dropping to the ground, kissing the ground, and just starting crying. But it really, I mean, even when Dylan hit the goal, you pretty much knew the game was over. And I was just kind of like, wow, we did it. And it was more just like amazement that this group of guys came together and played as well as they did.
It was I don't know the words for it. It was special, fantastic. It was indescribable. All 20 games coming to one point where you're the best team in Colorado is a pretty good feeling.
It's a great feeling. I mean, that's what we've been wanting for, and it's almost like a dream come true. It's like crazy. I still don't believe we did it.
It was crazy. It was a memory that I'm never gonna forget. It was just kind of like a perfect storm brewing. Before, when the brackets came out, I was like, oh, the state championship's on my birthday. It'd be crazy if something happened.
That is the story of our heroes, defying the odds, and how Grandview won their first boys soccer state title in the year 2021.